Hello and welcome to this special program brought to you by SAT TV. Joining me now is a special editor at CBS News, Mr. Peter Greenberg. He is in Dominica on a special mission. Peter, tell me, why are you in Dominica at this time?
Other than to meet you, I'm here because most of my audience has never been here. I'm the travel editor for CBS News, and most Americans, I'm sad to say, are geographically ignorant. They don't even know where Atlanta is, so where's Aruba? They don't know. And for many of us who are old enough to admit our age, most of us might remember Dominica from 1982 and the invasion of Grenada. That's about the only time they've heard about it, except if they looked at the credits of Pirates of the Caribbean or a few other movies that have been shot. They really don't know about this special place. They know about some of the more publicized locations, but here's an island that is small, it's manageable, it's volcanic. You're not going to come here for lots of beaches. You're going to come out here for everything else but the beaches. Water's great. Climbing, hiking, walking, nature, it's all here in a very manageable way.
So you landed on the island on Sunday, I believe?
No, I actually landed on the island yesterday.
Yesterday?
Yes.
And your mission is to do what?
Well, I'll be broadcasting my radio show, which is a nationwide show every week. We actually broadcast from a different location in the world every single week. Last week was Malta. Next week will be Marrakesh. And that's in Morocco. And guess what's right in the middle? Dominica.
So where did your itinerary take you on the island?
Everywhere. Starting here at the hotel, using it as a hub, getting out to the river areas, getting out to the actual water line, going up into the mountains, seeing some of the nature reserves, seeing some of the UNESCO sites. I mean, it's all there. And you know, one of the problems with UNESCO, if you look around the world, is there are so many of them, but they're not well preserved or well presented. You've got some here that are really well done, and people need to know about them.
What really struck you? What really caught your attention on the island so far?
Well, I can tell you this. It's not about the physical state of the island. It's not about the flora, the fauna. It's the people. It always is the people, isn't it? There are places that you'd go that you'd say, "Oh, I don't want to go there because it's foreboding or not welcoming." Until you get there, and what you find out is, people are generally happy to see you. And if you're happy to see them, guess what happens? You build bridges, boundaries get taken down, borders get written away, and you actually enjoy a great experience.
What is your underlying message that you're going to take back with you to the United States about Dominica?
Well, that message might surprise you. It's an island that shouldn't even have a brochure. And what I mean by that is all these other islands out there, they're so competitive, they have to have brochures, and every time you look at a brochure, the sun is setting nicely, and there's a size zero woman with breast enlarged and holding a wine glass and toasting. You don't need that here. That's the beauty of it. What you see is what you get. You don't need a brochure to discover Dominica, because all you have to do is get out of your room, turn left or turn right, and you're there. And for most Americans who think they need to have a plan, who think they need to have an organized schedule, no, this is not the place to do that. I would like to think that this is an island that can exist, survive, and succeed without a single brochure.
Talk to me about your experience accessing the island.
We want to talk about the roads. They're better than they used to be. They still have a long way to go. I mean, when first-time visitors come here and they tell you, "Oh, the roads are improved," they can't believe it, because they still can't understand how you make those turns, right? So if you're coming to Dominica, my advice to most travelers is have somebody else drive you. Don't rent a car. Don't even attempt it. You know, people go to Bermuda all the time and they rent the scooters. You know what happens? They hurt themselves. This is not the time to run the Baja 500. Get somebody knowledgeable. By the way, the taxi drivers here, they're all storytellers. Isn't that great? They all have a story to tell because they know everybody. This is an island where you know everybody. In fact, what your motto should be on the island is, "I know a guy." Because if you ask a question, "Hey, how can I do this?" "Oh, I know a guy." And you know what? They do know a guy. So my advice is come down here, don't rent the car, let the taxi driver tell you the story, and then go to those stories. And then guess what? Within 15 minutes, he's going to know a guy. And then you're going to find something that you couldn't believe you could do anywhere else in the world or anywhere else in the world better, and it's right here.
Who facilitated you to come to Dominica?
Well, my staff organized it through Discover Dominica. They understand what we do for a living in the United States. I'm not just the travel editor for CBS News. I also do my radio show, as you know. We're heard on over 400 stations every week, a large listenership. And the one thing about travel, which people don't realize, and you might realize it here in Dominica, but most people don't, it's the number one industry in the world. It provides the most number of jobs. One out of every 10 jobs is travel related. It puts food on the table. It feeds people. It hires people. In some countries, it's as much as 10% of their global GDP. That is huge, right? It is the world's largest business. It has to be here as well. And so I'm out there reporting on that in a way that hopefully is accessible to the audience so they can come and not just accomplish something, but actually experience it.
What happens once you leave the island?
I go to another island. But what happens after I leave this island is we'll edit my radio show, which we taped today. We'll edit all the footage that we shoot today and tomorrow into my show, which is called The Travel Detective on public television in the United States.
Travel Detective?
Correct. Think 60 minutes in Dateline of Travel. We're giving you an idea. We're giving you something that's not in the brochure. So how perfect is Dominica to be in that show? We're giving you something that you couldn't otherwise find on yourself unless you knew a guy. Well, in this particular case, I'm the guy.
So which areas in Dominica are you highlighting in this travel?
We're keeping that a little bit of a secret. Sorry about that.
And when will it be aired?
It'll be aired probably December, January, either late December this year or early January next year.
On CBS?
No, on public television.
On public television.
That's right. That's my show called The Travel Detective. The radio show will be airing in a couple of weeks because we always tape about a week or two ahead.
Okay. Peter Greenberg from CBS News in Dominica on a special mission. Thank you.
I like the word special mission. I'm going to adapt that everywhere I go. I'm on a special mission.